Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn about the chapter Prevention and Control of Aggression in Human Beings. The objectives of this lesson are, we are going to understand the several procedures and techniques that are useful in reducing the frequency and intensity of human aggression. Some of these techniques that are specified to us are punishment, cognitive interventions, catharsis, forgiveness, and apologies. Before we understand some of these procedures, let us try to understand the nature of aggression. Any emotion or feeling which ranges from a mild irritation to an extreme rage is called an aggression. Or any feeling which is causing displeasure or hostility can be termed as anger. Any feeling that causes displeasure or frustration can also be termed as anger. A reaction that comes out of frustration, humility, insult, or when others cause harm to us is called aggression. When a person is angry, the most commonly observable reactions in that person are, the person screams, yells, and shouts in a loud voice, or he tends to cry and become extremely sad, he refrains from talking to others, he becomes extremely hostile and unfriendly. Sometimes human beings tend to become unsympathetic to situations and people around them. Sometimes some other people tend to become irrational in their thoughts. They become very unruly. They become hostile. They attack and become violent when they are reacting to other people in aggression. Different people react to aggression in different societies in a different way. Be considered as an appropriate response to aggression, whereas in other cultures, the same raised voice may be considered as an offensive act and it will be considered as an aggressive action in some certain societies. Aggression must be considered multifactorially because there is no one solution to aggression and reducing the intensity and frequency of aggression. We have to understand that several researchers and studies have put forward many ideas to understand and give different solutions to this existing problem. A significant proportion of individuals who are considered as aggressive are sent to counseling centers and rehabilitation centers where they are diagnosed and understood and treated for their aggressive and hostile relationships. In these interventions, different procedures and techniques like punishment, cognitive interventions, catharsis, forgiveness, relaxation techniques are adopted by the therapists to understand and reduce the frequency of aggression. First thing is we are considering the technique of punishment. Before we understand the technique of punishment, let us probe into few certain questions as to why punishment is being used frequently in order to reduce the aggressive behavior and does this really work. In most societies, punishment is a major technique considered to be very effective in reducing aggressive behavior. We have to understand aggressive behavior. It's a delivery of aversive consequences to the individual who engages themselves in specific actions which are considered inappropriate to the organization and society at large. According to B.F. Skinner, punishment involves application of a stimulus to a behavior in order to reduce the occurrence and likelihood of that behavior to repeat again in the future. Let us look into some types of punishment in various societies that are incorporated by different cultures and different societies. Usually, a person who engages in inappropriate behavior is confined in a solitary confinement, or they receive huge amount of fines, or they are simply sent to prison. Whereas in some other countries, they receive physical punishment and they are treated very cruelly and rudely for their aggressive actions. In extreme cases, they tend to receive capital punishment and they are executed in various ways depending on the legal procedures of that country. Let us go back to the first question as to why punishment is considered and used so frequently in order to reduce aggression. Because it involves the belief that when individuals engage in acts of aggression, they tend to consider themselves inappropriate and they deserve a punishment for their inappropriate behavior. This perspective also suggests that the amount of punishment an individual receives depends on the amount of magnitude of harm that they caused to the society or another individual. This perspective involves the fact that the amount of punishment people receive depends on the magnitude of harm that they have caused to the individual or society at large. For example, if a person has broken somebody's arms or he is breaking the rules at the traffic signal, deserves a lesser punishment, whereas if the person tries to harm or insult or tries to kill someone, he deserves a stronger punishment. Does this mean that the greater the aggression and violence, the greater the punishment? This means that if aggressive action involves harm to others or the society at large, they should have to be strongly punished, because it is believed that only strong punishment will control and reduce the frequency of aggressive behavior and discourage people from involving in further aggressive actions. Let us come back to the second question as to, does punishment really work, or does it even prevent them from engaging in involving in further aggressive behavior in the future? In various experiments conducted by the researchers in the recent past, it is observed that children, when they are attended by caregivers, and if the caregivers ignore their aggressive behavior, they tend to reduce their aggressive actions, and if they are reinforced for their non-aggressive behavior, they tend to definitely reduce their aggression and behave in a more calmer, peaceful manner. Research also specifies that punishing the aggressor consistently is very less effective and doesn't show any reaction in the children. Does punishment really work? The question is, threatened punishment prevents aggression only under certain ideal conditions. Let us look at the text now and understand how this threatened punishment helps in reducing aggression. Threatened punishment prevents aggression when it is strong and timely, when it is prompt and sure, when it comes along with a reward for the desired behavior, and it represents, and when the recipient is communicated properly in a consoling manner, and when the communication is transparent and the recipient is not angry or is not in an angry mood, then it is likely that the recipient takes it in a very open manner, and then the threatened punishment is very effective in reducing aggression. Now let us look into the second aspect of techniques that is mentioned here in this chapter, which is called as cognitive intervention. Cognitive intervention is defined as a set of techniques or procedures used by a therapist to understand or investigate the thought process of an individual while they are learning, feeling, interacting, thinking, or problem solving. Emphasis is placed on the individual and understanding the individual's thought process before the anger is preceded. Therapists advise the individuals to determine whether their thought processes are rational or irrational depending on the situation or depending on the frequency of aggression that they are in. Because anger is an emotion which can have adverse effects and consequences, it's important for the individual to recognize his feelings at an early stage and try to determine them, whether they are rational or irrational. It's also better for the individual to approach a proper therapist or a counselor so that the counselor or therapist can redirect his emotions in an appropriate manner. Some of the techniques that the therapist suggests to the individuals depending on their situation are relaxation techniques, where the therapist suggests the individual to attend to a spa or take up some relaxation training programs. The therapist also sometimes suggests assertiveness training programs, where the individual is taught to learn to be assertive and express his emotions in a way that does not hurt the other individuals. The therapist also suggests communication skills to the individuals where the effective communication styles are considered to be learnt by the individual, where he learns the soft skills of communicating with other people in the society around him. The other techniques that the counselor suggests is the imaginary thinking is taught to be learning to become calm, serene and relaxed, and problem solving techniques like puzzles, games and competitions are taught to the individuals. Social skills trainings like communication styles, adjusting with other people in the society and behaving themselves in a group are also taught in form of workshops and seminars to the individuals by the therapists. Play therapy and music therapy are some of the therapies that are taught to individuals which will help them relax from their aggressive situation. The therapists, depending on the person and situation, suggests and advises different techniques to the individuals so that the negative feelings and the negative emotions are burned out and they are reflected and turned into constructive actions. Admission of wrongdoing that includes requests for forgiveness often goes a long way in trying to diffuse the aggressive behavior and reduce the frequency and intensity of aggression. An old saying goes that when emotion runs high, reason flies out of the windows. This means to say that the fact that when we are angry, our ability to reason out the consequences and evaluate the risks become reduced and we intend to behave irrationally. When we are triggered by aggressive thoughts, we lose the ability to rationalize our emotions and we behave in an irrational way. We forget to think clearly and we forget about the consequences of our actions. So in which case we unconsciously try to hurt others or harm others by our actions. This in turn increases the chances that we lash out against somebody or someone else, including those people who are not the cause for our annoyance or irritation. This kind of action is called displaced aggression, where we unintentionally tend to hurt the person or the people around us when they are actually not the reason for our annoyance. We displace our anger on them even without our unconscious effort, and we try to be aggressive to them, even if they are not the cause of our annoyance. With harmful words, harsh words, we intend to hurt them. This in turn increases the chance that we lash out against somebody, including those people who are not the cause for our irritation or annoyance. This is the displaced anger or aggression in psychological terms. So, if we are angry or we cause displaced anger on somebody, it is better that we apologize to that person by simply saying, "I'm sorry," because this diffuses a lot of aggression among human beings. Intentionally or unconsciously, we try to hurt others who are not the cause of our irritation or annoyance. So, the simple solution to this problem is to apologize to this person as early as possible and try to say sorry. Similarly, open communication, truthful explanations, and transparency is one of the best techniques that we can adopt in trying to reduce aggression among two people. By catharsis, we mean to say that we are trying to vent out our emotional, we are trying to release our emotions and feelings which are pent up and bottled up for a very long time. According to psychoanalytic theory, it is a ventilation of feelings which are unconscious conflicts from the childhood in a person which are vented out through cognitive interventions and catharsis. Catharsis allows an individual's tendencies to engage in actions that reduces aggression. Let us now look into the diagram that is shown in the picture. This is called a cathartic circle. If we look at the circle, the identification of the problem starts at the center of the circle, which says that it is where the individual tries to identify the problems of his own emotions. The second phase of this circle, as we can see, is either the individual accepts the emotions or undertakes them and takes up the responsibility of his own emotions. When he accepts the emotions, he either takes control of them or discharges those emotions which are unwanted. The second phase of undertaking the emotions, if he takes up the responsibility of those emotions, he tries to either express them or redirect them in a different way which are considered appropriate. This again transforms into two further stages, which takes into the form of either a switching over of an emotion or a transmutation or change of an emotion. Experiencing stress over a work related situation or feeling stressful about a work may cause feelings of frustration. This is the stage when the individual chooses to express his emotions in an appropriate way rather than inappropriate way. So, the individual is then suggested that he choose a relaxation technique or a proper music therapy or a play therapy, which is considered inappropriate, rather than involving himself in violent and harmful methods of expression. This purging of emotions or expression of emotions in an appropriate way by the individual is considered to be the act that he accepts and he undertakes as a responsibility for his own actions through a proper technique suggested by the therapist. In a psychotherapy, the therapist encourages the client or the individual to engage himself in actions or physical actions that are considered appropriate, so that this channelizes his energy into positive actions. Some therapists encourage their clients to engage themselves in actions which enact their aggression. For example, beating the beds with foam bats, or beating the pillow, or punching the punch bag, or trying to hit a doll while screaming. This helps the individual to ventilate his feelings that are bottled up in himself, and they ventilate their feelings through this kind of enactment. Catharsis is trying to emphasize on the individual's expression of their pent-up feelings in an appropriate manner, so that they can channelize their emotions in a positive manner. In children, catharsis allows children to engage themselves in an aggressive play, where children involve themselves in enactment with dolls and characters that they can relate with, and they try to bring out their emotions through these feelings or enactments. Through this kind of aggressive play, children try to release their emotional feelings and try to befriend other children, and tend to forget their aggressive and negative emotions very easily. Let us try to understand forgiveness as one of the other techniques in helpful in understanding how to reduce the aggression and its intensity. Surrendering to the desire to take a revenge, or surrendering the desire to harm others, is also known as forgiveness. Seeking to help others and act in a way that is causing kindness to others can be helpful technique in reducing aggression. In any given situation, when others are trying to harm us, the general reaction for any individual is to see that we retaliate and take revenge. But this kind of actions is reduced when the individual takes up a decision and decides that he is not going to retaliate anymore, and he is going to engage himself in kindful and calm acts that do not put him in risks. This kind of actions are known as forgiveness actions, where the individual involves himself and decides that he is not going to involve himself in revengeful actions. Individuals choose to surrender and give up the harmful actions so that their activities are engaged in more better constructive ways and helps them to become more resourceful individuals in the society. Under any given situation, if the individual is feeling threatened or being hurt by others, it is almost natural for him to retaliate and take revenge. But then people need to understand the reality and then go ahead with expressing their anger in an appropriate manner, which is constructive to everybody around them. Being assertive and trying to express themselves in a way that does not hurt others and hurt himself is an appropriate way of handling aggression. Now that we have understood all the techniques that are mentioned in the objectives of this chapter, let us quickly recapitulate the summary of whatever we have learned today. Some of the effective techniques helpful in reducing aggression are effective communication styles, social skills development, assertiveness training, relaxation training, communication in a proper way which does not hurt others, which is called as assertiveness training, forgiving others, apologizing others for the wrongdoings, play therapy, music therapy, and so on. Some of these techniques are very helpful in reducing aggressions in human beings, which are suggested by researchers and famous eminent psychologists.